New life in the UK test chapter 3. Test 8. A long and illustrious history. Early Britain. The Middle Ages. The Tudors and Stuarts. A global power. The 20th century. Britain since 1945. You have 45 minutes to answer 24 multiple choice life in the UK test questions. You need to answer at least 18 out of 24 questions correctly to pass. 1. Which famous leader said the following? We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the street, we shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. A. Admiral Nelson. B. Clement Attlee. C. Oliver Cromwell. D. Winston Churchill. Correct answer. Winston Churchill. Explanation. Churchill was the son of a politician and, before becoming a Conservative MP in 1900, was a soldier and journalist. In May 1940, he became Prime Minister. During the war, he made many famous speeches, including lines which you may still hear. I have nothing to offer but blood, toil, tears and sweat. Churchill's first speech to the House of Commons after he became Prime Minister, 1940. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. Speech to the House of Commons after Dunkirk, 1940. Is the statement below true or false? By around AD 600, Anglo-Saxon kingdoms were established in Britain. A. False. B. True. Correct answer. True. Explanation. The Roman army left Britain in AD 410 to defend other parts of the Roman Empire and never returned. Britain was again invaded by tribes from Northern Europe, the Jutes, the Angles and the Saxons. The languages they spoke were the basis of modern-day English. Battles were fought against these invaders, but by about AD 600, Anglo-Saxon kingdoms were established in Britain. These kingdoms were mainly in what is now England. Is the statement below true or false? Sir Robert Walpole was Prime Minister from 1700 to 1730. A. False. B. True. Correct answer. False. Explanation. The most important minister in Parliament became known as the Prime Minister. The first man to be called this was Sir Robert Walpole, who was Prime Minister from 1721 to 1742. Which of these statements is correct? A. The divine right of kings was the view held by many English monarchs that they could seize lands belonging to the nobility as they wished. B. The divine rights of kings was the view held by many English monarchs that they were directly appointed by God to rule. Correct answer. The divine rights of kings was the view held by many English monarchs that they were directly appointed by God to rule. Explanation. James I and his son Charles I were less skilled politically. Both believed in the divine right of kings, the idea that the king was directly appointed by God to rule. They thought that the king should be able to act without having to seek approval from Parliament. Who was James II's eldest daughter, Mary, married to? A. She never married. B. The Duke of York. C. The French Dauphin. D. William of Orange. Correct answer. William of Orange. Explanation. James II's elder daughter, Mary, was married to her cousin William of Orange, the Protestant ruler of the Netherlands. Is the statement below true or false? Commercial expansion and prosperity of the 19th century were sustained in part by the booming slave trade. A. False. B. True. Correct answer. True. Explanation. This commercial expansion and prosperity was sustained in part by the booming slave trade. While slavery was illegal within Britain itself, by the 18th century it was a fully established overseas industry, dominated by Britain and the American colonies. Is the statement below true or false? Richard Arkwright developed horse-driven spinning mills that used only one machine, increasing efficiency in production. A. False. B. True. Correct answer. True. Explanation. Born in 1732. Arkwright originally trained and worked as a barber. He was able to dye hair and make wigs. When wigs became less popular, he started to work in textiles. He improved the original carding machine. Carding is the process of preparing fibers for spinning into yarn and fabric. He also developed horse-driven spinning mills that used only one machine. This increased the efficiency of production. Later, he used the steam engine to power machinery. Arkwright is particularly remembered for the efficient and profitable way that he ran his factories. Which of these statements is correct? A. After the Black Death, there were labor shortages and peasants began to demand higher wages. B. The Black Death destroyed cereal crops, leading to a famine that killed many peasants. Correct answer. After the Black Death, there were labor shortages and peasants began to demand higher wages. Explanation. Following the Black Death, the smaller population meant there was less need to grow cereal crops. There were labor shortages and peasants began to demand higher wages. New social classes appeared, including owners of large areas of land, later called the gentry, and people left the countryside to live in the towns. In the towns, growing wealth led to the development of a strong middle class. After the Act of Union, Scotland was no longer an independent country. In what ways was it still separate from the rest of Great Britain? A. All of the above. B. It kept its own Presbyterian church. C. It kept its own educational system. D. It kept its own legal system. Correct answer. All of the above. Explanation. The Act of Union, known as the Treaty of Union in Scotland, was therefore agreed in 1707, creating the Kingdom of Great Britain. Although Scotland was no longer an independent country, it kept its own legal and education systems and Presbyterian church. Where did Florence Nightingale establish the Nightingale School for Nurses in 1860? A. Adam Brooks Hospital, Cambridge. B. Prince Philip Hospital, Llanelli. C. St. James's University Hospital, Leeds. D. St. Thomas's Hospital, London. Correct answer, St. Thomas's Hospital, London. Explanation. In 1860 she established the Nightingale Training School for Nurses at St. Thomas's Hospital in London. The school was the first of its kind and still exists today, as do many of the practices that Florence used. She is often regarded as the founder of modern nursing. After his campaign in Ireland and his defeat of Charles II, Oliver Cromwell was given what title? A. Chieftain. B. King. C. Lord Lieutenant. D. Lord Protector. Correct answer, Lord Protector. Explanation. After his campaign in Ireland and victory over Charles II at Worcester, Cromwell was recognized as the leader of the new republic. He was given the title of Lord Protector and ruled until his death in 1658. When Cromwell died, his son, Richard, became Lord Protector in his place but was not able to control the army or the government. Which of these statements is correct? A. The jet engine and radar were developed in Britain in the 1930s. B. The jet engine and radar were developed in Britain in the 1950s. Correct answer. The jet engine and radar were developed in Britain in the 1930s. Explanation. Radar was developed by Scotsman Sir Robert Watson, 1892-1973, who proposed that enemy aircraft could be detected by radio waves. The first successful radar test took place in 1935. The jet engine was developed in Britain in the 1930s by Sir Frank Whittle, 1907-96, a British Royal Air Force engineer officer. Britain was brought into conflict with which country during the 19th century, because they were expanding and trading in similar areas? A. France. B. Germany. C. Spain. D. The Netherlands. Correct answer, France. Explanation: trading and settlements overseas sometimes brought Britain into conflict with other countries, particularly France, which was expanding and trading in a similar way in many of the same areas of the world. Is the statement below true or false? The Puritans agreed with the religious reforms of the Church of England introduced by Charles I. False. B. True. Correct answer, false. Explanation. Charles I wanted the worship of the Church of England to include more ceremony and introduced a revised prayer book. He tried to impose this prayer book on the Presbyterian Church in Scotland, and this led to serious unrest. A Scottish army was formed, and Charles could not find the money he needed for his own army without the help of Parliament. In 1640, he recalled Parliament to ask it for funds. Many in Parliament were Puritans, a group of Protestants who advocated strict and simple religious doctrine and worship. They did not agree with the king's religious views and disliked his reforms of the Church of England. Which two of the following were members of the Royal Society? A. Samuel Pepys. B. Sir Christopher Wren. C. Sir Edmund Halley. D. Sir Isaac Newton. Correct answer, Sir Edmund Halley and Sir Isaac Newton. Explanation. Charles II was interested in science. During his reign, the Royal Society was formed to promote natural knowledge. This is the oldest surviving scientific society in the world. Among its early members was Sir Edmund Halley, who successfully predicted the return of the comet now called Halley's Comet, and Sir Isaac Newton. What was the main source of employment in the UK before the Industrial Revolution? A. Agriculture. B. Canal building. C. Financial services. D. The wool trade. Correct answer, agriculture. Explanation. Before the 18th century, agriculture was the biggest source of employment in Britain. There were many cottage industries where people worked from home to produce goods such as cloth and lace. During the 1960s, Parliament passed new laws that made it illegal for employers to discriminate against women because of their gender and gave them which right? A. Childcare at work. B. Equal pay. C. Free lunches. D. 2 years maternity leave. Correct answer, equal pay. Explanation. It was quite common at the time for employers to ask women to leave their jobs when they got married. But Parliament passed new laws giving women the right to equal pay and made it illegal for employers to discriminate against women because of their gender. The Wars of the Roses was fought by the supporters of which two families in order to decide who should be King of England. A. The House of Lancaster. B. The House of Tudor. C. The House of Windsor. D. The House of York. Correct answer, the House of Lancaster and the House of York. Explanation. In 1455, a civil war was begun to decide who should be King of England. It was fought between the supporters of two families, the House of Lancaster and the House of York. This war was called the Wars of the Roses, because the symbol of Lancaster was a red rose and the symbol of York was a white rose. Is the statement below true or false? Under the system of feudalism, the kings gave land to lords, and the landowners had to send men to serve in the army in return. A. False. B. True. Correct answer, true. Explanation. The Normans used a system of land ownership known as feudalism. The king gave land to his lords in return for help in war. Landowners had to send certain numbers of men to serve in the army. In 1649, England was declared a republic. What was it called? A. European Wealth. B. Great Britain. C. The Commonwealth. D. The People's Republic. Correct answer, the Commonwealth. Explanation. The king's army was defeated at the battles of Marston Moor and Naseby. By 1646, it was clear that Parliament had won the war. Charles was held prisoner by the parliamentary army. He was still unwilling to reach any agreement with Parliament, and in 1649 he was executed. England declared itself a republic called the Commonwealth. It no longer had a monarch. Who or what were the clans? A. English lords. B. Prominent families in England and Wales. C. Prominent families in Scotland and Ireland. D. Welsh landowners. Correct answer. Prominent families in Scotland and Ireland. Explanation. In the north of Scotland and Ireland, land was owned by members of the clan's prominent families. In 1948, an Éireann, Ní Bheven, led the establishment of the National Health Service, NHS. What was his role at the time? A. Deputy Prime Minister. B. Home Secretary. C. Minister for Health. D. Minister for Social Security. Correct answer, Minister for Health. Explanation. In 1948, an Éireann, Ní Bheven, the Minister for Health, led the establishment of the National Health Service, NHS, which guaranteed a minimum standard of healthcare for all, free at the point of use. A national system of benefits was also introduced to provide social security, so that the population would be protected from the cradle to the grave. Who were Elizabeth I's parents? A. Henry VII and Elizabeth of York. B. Henry VIII and Anne Boleyn. C. Henry VIII and Catherine of Aragon. D. Henry VIII and Jane Seymour. Correct answer, Henry VIII and Anne Boleyn. Explanation. Mary was a devout Catholic and persecuted Protestants. For this reason, she became known as Bloody Mary. Mary also died after a short reign, and the next monarch was her half-sister, Elizabeth, the daughter of Henry VIII and Anne Boleyn, which Catherine was executed after being accused of taking lovers by Henry VIII. A. Boleyn. B. Howard. C. Aragon. D. Parr. Correct answer. Howard. Explanation. Catherine Howard. Catherine was a cousin of Anne Boleyn. She was also accused of taking lovers and executed.